Hey everyone, Tim Schofield here. It's time to do my full review on the latest flagship from Samsung, the Galaxy S9 Plus. And this year, Samsung has decided to add extra features to the Plus variant, so yes, this is their flagship at the moment. I've had tons of time with the S9 Plus, including hands-on time before launch. I've been using it as my daily phone for a good amount of time now, so let's go ahead and get into my full review of the Samsung Galaxy S9 Plus. The S9 Plus design didn't change a lot from last year's model, and that's okay because this is one of the best looking phones out there right now with those curved sides allowing the content to just sort of spill over the side of the display. This gives it a really nice look. I really do like it. And a lot of people complained on the previous model that the sides were a little bit too thin with the curved display. However, this year's model, they went with a more flat side look, so there's definitely more space to grab onto, which makes it easier to hold onto. The fingerprint scanner on the S8 Plus was really, really difficult to press. However, that is fixed with this model, so an upgrade with the fingerprint scanner, very easy to reach, very accurate and quick. This year, the S9 Plus has a dual camera system over the single camera on the S9, so that is part of the upgrade. More on the camera in just a second. You still have a heart rate sensor right there, which you can actually tap to snap pictures on your phone. That's just a setting in the camera app. Now, a trade-off for having very minimal bezels is that you can't have dual front-firing speakers. You have one with the earpiece right here and one more down at the bottom. So a bottom-firing one, but they work in conjunction for stereo sound. And I actually do really like these speakers. They get very loud, and also the quality doesn't distort as you turn it up. So I've been very pleased. These are above average stereo speakers. I do wish they were front facing, but again, you would have to sacrifice the aesthetics of the phone. The S9 Plus also has features that make it stand out above the competition, including that of a headphone jack. Unfortunate that I have to mention that. And expandable storage up to 400 gigs. So if you use a micro SD card, you can really up the storage of this phone. There is an IP68 rating, so dust and water resistance. You don't have to worry about if you drop it in some water or if it's raining outside. Also noteworthy, the back is glass, so it is a fingerprint magnet. I didn't clean this phone before the video, and as you can tell, lots of grease, lots of fingerprints. I find that I have to regularly clean the back of the device, but with a glass back comes a nice feature of wireless charging, and it has fast wireless charging, which isn't as quick as if you plugged it in, but it is still quick. This brings us to the sponsor of this video, and that would be RAV Power with their new Hyper Air wireless chargers. The Hyper Air has a 10-watt fast wireless charging, which is perfect for the S9 Plus that I have, and even a temperature adjustment chip, which monitors and adjusts charging temperature, so you don't have to worry about that. These two, you both have to plug in, and you'll see it does have ventilation down at the bottom and grips. And then this one is more of a stand, which is perfect for at your desk. You do have to plug it in, but again, you have some ventilation for that fast wireless charging. And finally, you have a completely portable wireless charging system with a 10,400 milliamp hour battery pack. It even has an output for USB type A, so you can charge another device wirelessly and cable. And then if you press the button, you'll see you have an indicator light on the side and then the battery charging level down at the bottom. I've been testing out all three and have been very happy with them. If you're interested in purchasing one, I will post all the links down below, even with some discount codes provided by RAV Power. The S9 Plus has a 6.2-inch 2960 by 1440 Super AMOLED display. And as usual, Samsung has put out the best display on any phone right now. With it being Super AMOLED, the always-on display is great because, of course, it only lights up these pixels, lets you know your notifications. You also have a 3D touch-style home button as well, similar to that on the S8 that you can press on any screen to take you home or wake the display. And again, that display is gorgeous. Whether you're watching videos, playing games, it is sincerely the best display on any phone right now. It does have a little bit of an odd aspect ratio, 18.5:9. So you'll see you do have a couple black bars on your videos. You can actually pinch in to fill all the way, but it does crop part of the video out. But of course, it makes for an amazing viewing experience with, again, that content just spilling off the display of that curved design. Great job, Samsung, with their Super AMOLED displays. The S9 Plus has a 3,500 milliamp hour battery, which does last me all day. It's not the best battery life on any phone I've ever used, but it easily gets me through a full day without having to actually charge it midday, which is perfect for me. I get about 4 hours and 50 minutes screen on time average which is definitely above average for me. Average is about 4 hours and 15 minutes. And on the back of the S9 Plus is that dual camera system, making for very versatile photos. One is a telephoto lens, so you get 2x optical zoom without losing any quality. And there's even a switch embedded in the camera, which will actually change the aperture from 1.5 to 2.4, depending on the lighting. The camera app is one of the most feature-rich out right now, complementing that dual camera system. So you have a lot of different shots that you have the ability to take. Of course, including that 2x zoom, up to 2x optical zoom. You can do some tweaking with your zooming by using the button here. Or, of course, there is a 2x button that pops up right there, so you can quickly swap between that 1x and 2x lens. Now, it's also worth noting, it doesn't always use that telephoto lens, which is this bottom one. And to test that, I will go ahead and cover up the lens when it's in use, which will be now. So I know it's in use because my finger's covering up the bottom lens, but if it's not a good lighting scenario, it may or may not use that telephoto lens. It might actually just use digital zoom. So keep that in mind. The telephoto lens is really only gonna work when it's a better lighting scenario. There's a really good super slow-mo mode. It can auto-detect motion and get some slow motion shots. Here's an example of just me blowing some bubbles at Samsung's office. It works how it should. It's very good. There is a live focus mode, which works very well at detecting an object and blurring everything else around it. Here's an example shot that I took. You'll see it cut around the edges and blurred everything else in the background. And not only do you get the close-up shot, but you can actually see the wide-angle shot if you'd like to. So it actually captures two separate pictures. And after you take it, you can actually adjust the background blur. So if you want less background blur, you'll see you can just go ahead and do so. Lots of customization options with this mode. The camera app has a pro mode, so you can change your white balance, ISO, aperture, all that good stuff on the fly and manually control it. From what I found, the front-facing camera is just okay. It allows for actually a selfie focus mode to actually focus on, similar to that live focus mode, and blur everything else, or even a wide selfie where you snap a picture and then pan to the sides to get multiple people in a shot. And then there is AR emoji, which you have your own emoji, and here is mine right here. As you can see, it scanned my face and went ahead and made. You'll see it's following my face. I'm looking at the front-facing camera and the lips should be following me, even my facial motions, all that stuff. So I do have a hat on as well, so it's probably messing with it, but it works okay. But for me, it's goofy. I don't necessarily ever use this feature, but it is there if you'd like to use it. I want to take a look at a couple point and shoot shots that I took with the rear camera. And you'll see here, this is just of the city towards nighttime, with a lot of different lights going on, and it did a really good job at capturing some good detail on the shot. This is also a shot I took in a much darker room than it shows. So when you actually take low light shots, it really brightens up the image, and they're actually very sharp. Sometimes coloring looks a little off, not in this photo. This photo was really good considering how little amount of light I actually had in my bathroom. Yet another shot I took at 5 a.m. in the dark. You see there's a bunny right there. I even zoomed in on it. And it actually captured a good amount of detail considering the low light. I just find that coloring gets a little off when taking shots in low light, but it still is a very, very good camera in low light scenarios. One of the best out there. And of course, in good lighting, the shots you take are fantastic, compete with all the best phones out there right now. And you get that telephoto lens. So when you are in a good lighting scenario, you have the option to zoom in, which is very useful for me. Next up is speed and performance. It has the latest Snapdragon 845 processor coupled with 6 gigs of RAM, which makes the S9 a little bit better in that aspect, considering the S9 only has 4 gigs. So it's a little bit better at RAM management than the S9 will be. Now, if I go ahead and press home and I wanna go ahead and quick swap to some apps, we can go ahead and go through. Here is the Play Store. If I wanna go ahead and go into an app, scroll down, read some reviews. Maybe let's go do Relay and check Reddit real quick. Maybe load up or refresh the page. We can go into a calculator, do a quick calculation, times 6. And then I can maybe press the power button twice to open up the camera. And you'll see everything's very smooth. Everything's very quick, snappy. I've had no trouble with RAM management closing out apps unnecessarily. So performance is fantastic. You can run all the high-end games that you'd like, especially with gaming becoming more and more prominent on mobile. This phone does a perfect job at that, especially when I swipe over. It has game tools, and you can do a couple different things with the game tools. You have navigation key lock. One thing that I really was glad you can enable is auto brightness lock, because of course with the slim bezels, you have the sensors all up at the top. When you game, you actually block that brightness sensor, so you can actually lock that so it doesn't completely darken your screen. A nice little addition. You can turn off alerts or hard press home button lock. So if I turn that off, I can actually hard press the home button and go back home. The phone ships with Android 8.0 Oreo, which isn't the latest. Android 8.1 Oreo is the latest. And considering the S8's track record of updates, you're gonna have to wait a little bit longer than you would, say, the Pixel for your updates to occur. So just kind of keep that in mind when you purchase the phone. With this iteration, I've actually stuck with the home launcher. I do really like it. It has badges when you do have notifications. Swipe up to get to your app drawer, swipe down anywhere to get to your notification tray is fantastic. There is Bixby integration with a dedicated button, and I find it to be more of a nuisance when I accidentally press the button. They need to add an option to remap this button. Plain and simple, if I could remap it to the Google Assistant or maybe even a specific app, that would be fantastic, but you cannot. I will just shut off the button so I don't accidentally keep pressing it. Very quickly, a feature this phone has that I think a lot of people forget is opening up two apps at once and setting a shortcut for it. So real quick, I just added this relay for Reddit and settings, and both of those just opened at the same time. So if I wanna close out of one and I'll exit out of the other and I'll open it up again, just watch how quick that actually snaps into the dual screen mode. So if you have a couple apps, maybe YouTube and your messaging app that you have open a lot, you can quickly snap between them. And then of course you have an option when you press on the middle button, you can actually open it in a pop-up window. So it will pop up, you can minimize it, and then it's just a little icon. To quickly get into that mode, you just swipe from the corner and then you are in a smaller window mode. So multitasking on the S9 Plus is definitely one of the best out there, allowing you for having a bunch of different apps open at once in smaller screens. And of course, with the display size being so large, you might want to minimize the screen a little bit. So there is a quick shortcut to get into a one-handed mode. You just swipe up from the corner and it will go ahead and make it a little bit smaller to reach those corners of the display. There's a new intelligent scan feature which combines face unlock and iris scanning to unlock your phone. It's very quick, very accurate, works in the dark, works how it should. However, I'm not a big fan of the iris scanner because you'll see here when I actually unlock the phone, it looks for my irises, and notice that flickering red light up there. That's not just the camera actually detecting that. You see that with your naked eye. So if you're out maybe at a bar or at a dinner or something, I found a couple people ask me, why does your phone flicker red like that? It's just a little annoying to see that. So I've had to turn it off, which is fine because of course you do have a backup of that very convenient fingerprint scanner right there that I've just used consistently. And you can still use Face Unlock if you don't like that iris scanner. There are so many added features to TouchWiz, which is the skin over Android. It would take forever to go over all of them. You do have a theme option with wallpapers, icons, even always on display theming. So tons of theming options. And then you have advanced features, and there are just loads of these. As you can see, I'm just gonna scroll through them. Direct call, smart alert. You have a dual messenger feature if you have a couple different accounts in a messenger app. Video enhancer, touch sensitivity for a use with screen protector. As you can see, when you really dive into the OS, they've added so many different features. And to finish everything off, I want to give some final thoughts on the S9 Plus. And this is definitely one of the best phones I've ever used, just all around design, camera, battery life, has a headphone jack, has expandable storage. It has tons of selling points. Now, is it a worthy upgrade over the S8 Plus? Probably not. You will like the upgrade, but I just don't think it's worth the actual money to upgrade alone. But if you're coming from any other device, it's definitely gonna be a big upgrade. This is a really great phone. So anyways, that's it on the Galaxy S9 Plus. I hope you enjoyed the review. Click that thumbs up if you did. Be sure to subscribe. A lot more videos to come in the near future. And as always, guys, thank you very much for watching.